Hello, welcome to this video tutorial. In a short time, we will get a general overview on all the features you need to know to start using Adobe After Effects CC Release 2019. Leave us comments and suggestions below this video to help us improve our next video tutorials dedicated to Adobe Creative Cloud. Adobe After Effects is one of the most advanced video editing products, enhancing videos with outstanding visual and audio effects, text, and professional post-processing features. As other Creative Cloud products, this is available just under a subscription plan. To learn more about the other products inside Creative Cloud, check out our link inside the video description. When opening After Effects, the home screen page shows up, divided in several sections on the left. Under Home, you can get your first tutorial on how to use After Effects and more information about it if you need. As you work with After Effects, this page also shows your most recent projects made at the bottom, under Recent. Under Learn, you can find several video tutorials dedicated to specific features. Use Sync Settings to sync and import your own settings. In addition, use New Project to start with a new After Effects project, or Open Project to open an existing one. In order to see how to use After Effects, let's start with a new project. The main interface is a workspace made by different windows, and also by several editing tools placed in the top left corner. In particular, you can use the Home button to come back to the home screen page if you need. All the windows and panels move and change according to the workspace chosen in the top right corner. In this video, we just use the default one, but you can also try the Learn workspace to open the Learn panel, collecting several tips and suggestions as you work with your project. In the central part, you have the preview called Composition Window, used to check your work in progress. Below, you have the project timeline, where you edit and manage all your media files imported. On the left and right sides, other windows collect several features and properties we will see. In case any window is missing, you can recover it by using the Window tab. Let's understand the basic structure of an After Effects project. This is made by several independent structures called compositions, representing single and custom videos made, starting from media files or footages, which can be audio, video files, or pictures. In this beginner tutorial, we will work with a single composition for simplicity. To add media files inside your project, just drag and drop these from any folder to the project timeline. All these imported files are also listed under the project window on the left, complete with file name, format, and size. These files are collected as simple links, so in case they are moved or deleted, they become offline and unavailable, with their name in italic style. You can recover any file by right-clicking on it and going to Replace Footage, File, browsing for the missing file in your computer. To start editing these files, you have to create a new composition first. Click on the New Composition button and use the new dialog box to adjust its settings, such as its name on top, and all its video and audio properties under Basic. Use Preset to pick a ready template to use and customize it as you like at the bottom, changing the video size with width and height, the frame rate, or video frames per second, the video resolution, and the maximum composition duration in seconds. Once you are ready, click on OK to create the composition. The new composition opens directly on both the timeline and the preview above, and is also listed inside the project window, just like a footage. In case you need to adjust again the composition settings, just right-click on it and go to Composition Settings. Once you have a composition open on the timeline, you can import your files by clicking and dragging these from the project window into the timeline. These are added as several rows called layers, with file name and properties on the left, and colored rectangles or clips on the right, extended in time as much as their content lasts, and with a different color depending on the kind of media file. The composition window, or preview, is used to check your footages and your compositions in progress inside the timeline. Double-click on any source file inside the project window to preview it directly. If you double-click on a composition, this opens on both the timeline and the preview, showing the result of all your modifications made, in particular, where the blue marker is placed in time. Click on the timeline to place the marker, or click and drag it to check the composition content frame by frame. To play back and pause the composition, audio, or video footages in real time, just use the spacebar key. Consider that the first preview may not be good until the green rendering bar gets completed in the interested part. This rendering allows to get a uniform and fine preview on the timeline content up to your next modifications made of it. You can also use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out on the preview. To pan through it, just hold down the spacebar key and click and drag. Now, let's see how to edit media files inside the timeline. To zoom in and out on the timeline, just use your mouse wheel while holding down the Alt key. To move through time, just use the mouse wheel with the Shift key. To move any clip in time, click and drag it. Consider that this also resets the green rendering bar above. In case multiple visual clips get overlapped in time, the preview shows the layer that is at the top in front of all the other layers placed in a lower position. You can click and drag a layer up or down from the left side to change their order and so their visibility on the preview. To stretch or shorten the duration of any clip in time, click and drag from its edges. Video and sound clips also show black corners, indicating that their content has a limited duration. This means that you can't stretch these indefinitely, and you cut part of their content if you shorten these. Another possible way to stretch and shorten your clips is to change their playback or speed rate. If you right-click on a clip and go to Time, Time Stretch, you can set the stretch factor percentage below 100% to fasten the clip and make it shorter in time, or above 100% to slow the clip and make it last longer in time. This effect won't change anything regarding the clip content. Use Control or Command and Z to undo any of your latest actions. To cut, copy, and paste any clip, select its layer from the left side and use Control or Command and X, C, and V. You can cut a layer to remove and delete it. When you paste, a new copy of the interested layer is made on a new layer row. On the extreme left, you have several options to manage each layer inside the composition. Use the eye icon to hide or show the visual content of a layer. The speaker icon to mute or unmute its audio content. And the solo button to hide all the layers except the interested one. Enable the lock button to block any possible modification on the layer content until you disable it. To rename a layer, just right-click on it and go to Rename. In addition, click on the gray arrow to show the full list of properties for each layer, depending on its kind of content. Audio layers have the audio section, where you can adjust the volume with audio levels and check the sound waveform under Waveform. Pictures and photos show the Transform section, used to adjust position, the content size with scale, its inclination with rotation around a center called anchor point, and the transparency level with opacity. Video layers have both the audio and the transform sections. To edit these properties, click and drag on the blue values, or just click once on these to type in directly, applying with the Enter key. Click on Reset above to reset all the properties within the chosen section. To check your modifications, make sure to open the preview on the current composition and place its blue marker on the clip you want to modify. You can also use the main preview to modify your visual clips. With the selection tool enabled, select the layer interested and click and drag it to move it within the preview and use its nodes to scale it. With the rotation tool, you can click and drag the clip to rotate it. On the right, the Effects and Presets panel collects all the visual and audio effects available inside After Effects. Choose the effect from the list and drag and drop it on the interested layer. This will be added inside a new section called Effects, collecting all the effects and their properties applied on the layer. For the complete list of effects properties, use the Effect Controls window on the left. You can also use the FX icon to enable and disable each effect. To remove one indefinitely, just select it and use Control or Command and X. The transitions are special visual effects used to introduce or end a clip. For example, at the end of a clip, place the blue marker where the transition should start and enable the timer button next to Completion. Then, at the end of the clip, change the completion property from 0 to 100%. You can also add transitions at the beginning of the clip with the difference that the completion percentage goes from 100% to 0% in time. And you can edit and manage its properties just like the other effects. Inside After Effects, you can also add pieces of text with the type tools. Enable any type tool and click and drag on the preview to create a text box used to delimit the text content. Then type inside, horizontally or vertically, depending on the kind of type tool you have chosen. In case you do not see text properly, make sure to enlarge the text box enough. The piece of text is represented on the timeline as a red text layer, which can be edited and managed as seen for other layers. You can also use the Transform section or the Selection and the Rotation tools to move, scale, and rotate text on the preview. To edit the text content and its properties, double-click on the text layer and use the Character window on the right to adjust the font family, size, distribution, style, and color. Consider that these changes are applied just on the selected piece of text you have on the preview. Now let's see how to save and export your work. To save your current project, go to File and then to Save As twice, setting file name and location. This .aep project file saves any composition, link, and any property or effect applied on each layer. To render your compositions into videos to play back and upload outside, you have to use the Render Queue window. First of all, add any of the compositions to be rendered by selecting this and then going to the Composition tab, Add to Render Queue. This composition will appear inside the Render Queue window with all its default rendering settings. Under Render Settings, choose Quality, Resolution, and Frame Rate to use. The video size is indeed fixed by the composition settings. On Output Mode, choose the file format to use and the color code below. You can also resize and crop the video if you need. At the bottom, set the audio sample rate and its depth. On Output 2, set the video name and where to save it. Once defined, the composition gets the queued status and is ready to be exported. At this point, enable it on the left and click on the Render button to start rendering. Each of these compositions are rendered according to their own work area, located right below the main timeline. It is always rendered just what falls within such region. You can place and shorten its property in order to choose which part of the composition must be exported. Thanks for watching this video. Please check out and subscribe to our channel to discover more and free video tutorials on Creative Cloud.